Hey guys, in this video, I'm going to go over this time series problem. It says assume that the observations x1, x2, and also x4, we're not going to use that in this problem, are from the moving average 1 model, and then it gives you the following moving average 1 model. Find the best linear predictor of the missing value x3 in terms of x1 and x2, and compute the mean square errors for the best linear predictor. So this is telling you you have an MA1 and it's asking you to find the best linear predictor for the third term and assuming you're given the first two terms. So the general formula for this would be x3 is equal to a0 plus a1 xn plus a2 xn minus 1. And in this case, that's going to be a0 plus a1 x2 plus a2 x1. And we have to solve, so this is a linear combination of constants and variables. And we have to basically solve for a0, a1, and a2. So let's go ahead and get started. So the formula for the intercept a0 is often 0, but the formula for that is mu 1 minus the autocorrelation function at lag h. And for the moving average 1 model, if you do the expected value, mu is equal to the expected value of xt, and for the moving average model, that's just going to be 0. So a0 is going to be 0. And oftentimes when I do these problems, a0 is equal to 0, but you do have to prove it before you move on. So really, we just have to find a1 and a2. So to find that, I'm going to do some matrix multiplication. So the way I think of having to do this is on the left-hand side, my left-hand vector is going to be the autovariance functions of the predictor and the covariates. So in this case, the covariates are x2 and x1. So I'm going to do the covariance of x3, x2, covariance of x3, x1, and that's my left-hand side vector is equal to, and then for this matrix, I do a covariance matrix of the covariances and variances of the covariates. So I know covariance and covariates sound the same, but I mean that this is going to be the covariance of x2, x2. In other words, the variance of x2. And this is going to be the covariance of x2 and x1. This is going to be the covariance of x1, x2. And this is going to be the covariance of x1, x1. And I'm going to multiply that by what we're looking for, which are a1 and a2. So we can rewrite this using just gamma, and then these are just lags. So this is going to be the autocovariance function for a lag of 1. So from x3 to x2, that's just 1 lag. From x3 to x1, that's 2 lags. So it's gamma 2 is equal to gamma 0, which is also the variance. This is equal to gamma 1, gamma 1, gamma 0. And before I try to multiply and then solve for a1, a2, I'm going to convert the autocovariance functions, so the gammas, into rows, the autocorrelation functions. So the formula for that is that rho h is equal to gamma h divided by gamma 0. So really what we're just doing is for every element that has a gamma, we're just going to divide by gamma 0. And this will make the multiplication more simple later on. So this is going to be rho 1, this is going to be rho 2, is equal to gamma 0 divided by gamma 0 is just 1, so the main diagonal has turned into 1. This is going to be rho 1, rho 1, a1, a2. For lag 2, on a moving average 1 model, lag 2, anything greater than lag 1, will be 0. So this is just 0. When you divide by the variance, you're still going to get 0, so this is just 0. And now we've simplified the multiplication, the matrix multiplication. Let's go ahead and write out the two equations that this gives us. So that's going to be rho 1 is equal to a1 plus a2 rho 1, or rho 1 a2. And then the second line gives us 0 is equal to rho 1 a1 plus a2. Then what I did was I solved for a2, so that's going to be equal to negative rho 1 a1. And I plugged that into the first equation. So rho 1 is equal to a1 plus rho 1, and then I plugged in a2, so that's negative rho 1 a1. So rho 1 is equal to a1 plus or minus row 1 squared a1. Let's factor out an a1, so that's 1 minus row 1 squared. So a1 is equal to row 1 over 1 minus row 1 squared. And now let's solve for a2 by plugging back in a1. So it's going to be negative row 1 times row 1 divided by 1 minus row 1 squared. So that's going to be negative row 1 squared over 1 minus row 1 squared. And if we want to get rid of the negative on the numerator, that's going to be row 1 squared over row 1 squared minus 1. So we're just multiplying by negative 1 on the numerator and the denominator. And now we know that the best linear predictor for x3, given x1 and x2, is a1 times x2. So that's going to be row 1 over 1 minus row 1 squared x2 plus a2 x1, so that's going to be row 1 squared over row 1 squared minus 1 x3. And I would leave it just like that. And I guess if you want to prove that you know what row 1 for an MA1 model is, that's going to be gamma 1 over gamma 0. So the variance for an MA1 model is sigma squared times 1 plus theta squared. And for log 1, the covariance is going to be sigma squared theta. So row 1 is just theta over 1 plus theta squared. And so this is your final answer for the best linear predictor. And the second part of the question says to basically compute the mean squared predictive error. So there's a formula for that as well, and that is gamma 0 minus AN transpose times gamma H. Gamma 0, we've already said that's sigma squared 1 plus theta squared minus, this is just the vector of the constants that we were trying to find, so that's A1, A2. And then this, I always just think of it as the left-hand side of the equations that we already solved for, so that's going to be gamma 1, 0. And if we multiply these two vectors, that's going to be a1 gamma 1. So that's going to be equal to sigma squared times 1 plus theta squared minus, what's a1? A1 is row 1 over 1 minus row 1 squared. And then gamma 1 is just sigma squared theta. So this is our final answer for the mean squared predictive error. And we're done with this problem.